Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Bearable Bull here. And I got this aggressively average content for you today. But I'm seeing massive indications that we're gonna go up from here. And let me show you why with this massive one right now. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me briefly pivot our attention back to this XRP case very quickly. As the other day, Commissioner Hester Pierce and Roizman from the SEC are combating their own organization. They're helping Ripple in this case because they see the absurdity of their own SEC. Ripple filing in support of fair notice defense states that Commissioners Pierce and Roizman have candidly explained that there is a decided lack of clarity for market participants in the crypto space. And Jeremy Hogan states attorney Kellogg understands how great this argument is and is going to be. If a reasonable person doesn't have any clarity in July 2021, how the hell did they have it back in 2019-17 before the big Dow guidance, or even back in 2013? Ladies and gentlemen, it's a foregone conclusion that Ripple's going to win this case. The only question is when, and the only question is if we're going to get a settlement sooner than we expect. With Hinman's deposition coming July 27th, and Elizabeth Warren asking for SEC clarity the 28th, I think it was likely we would have gotten a settlement in September. But now, it's a very real possibility we could get a settlement before that.
But oh wow, what a blessing from the heavens this letter is for Ripple. It's sweet, heavenly, fair notice, nectar of the gods. Notice how the letter and the excerpts are written with the focus on third parties, people, and the marketplace. That is exactly what you were praying for.
Fam dancing, that rocket got stealth. Shitcoin, put it on the shelf. We headed towards the wealth. BTC, Maxi, Patsy, Moon fam clapping, they could not tell. Sheep trying to sell when it didn't turn out well. Blink of an eye, red candle, it all fell. Bitcoin was a demo, you ain't get the memo. Net memos, SEC said though, we blasting off the ghetto. Big bags on me, middle finger to the devils. Rocket fly itself, no keys, no pedals. To the top, I need a medal. Stay holy in my temple, ripple net my bezel. Never sold, I never settled. Knew what I hold was special. I knew the fundamentals, flipped the switch. Oh, it was accidental. Big bags, yeah, I got several. Got rockets for rentals. Moonship my vessels. You could not meddle. It was all mental. Crypto ghost rebels. Go kick moon pebbles. I'll send you moon petals. My spaceship invisible. It fly real gentle. The SEC settled. We blasting off the ghetto.
Big stars just aligned on this one, my friends. I mean, it was almost like the commissioners took the opportunity presented specifically to help Ripple.
Show, they want you out for show. Now they've been exposed. Why your lawsuit on your last day going out the dough? Got you on that blockchain trail. SEC getting paid in ether. Bitcoin hella slow, do some research. I don't wanna be your crypto teacher. Stop asking me what to buy, it's on my t-shirt. New commander in the rocket, by the leaf earth. The SEC settled, we blasting off the ghetto. Big bags on me, middle fingers to the devils. Rocket fly itself, no keys, no pedals. Ripple net memos.
Securities market will be attached to tokens, NFTs. I think we will find, you know, all financial instruments will go that way. Because why? We can settle instantaneously. We can trade 24 hours a day. And it doesn't cost anything to do it.
Stay holy in my temple, ripple net my bezel. Never sold, I never settled. Knew what I hold was special.
Fam, what's up, Claire Army? You all know what time it is. It's Financial Fridays with your boy Bat. Coming in hot, this is a special one. The narrative's playing out. We got that intel, we're the army. We're looking clairvoyant. I can't tell you when it's gonna happen. I can get you prepared. I like my seat down low and my window slightly cracked, riding with a bad hoe and her girlfriend in the back. I do this for fun. If you don't like what's on my mind, get to the back of the line. While you're there, you can kiss my behind while I sip on this opus wine. Now get out of your bed, get out of your head. Look in the mirror, tell yourself you're the biggest. We ride together, we die together. Get your wet wipes. You're about to be splashed with some financial
success. Why the hell would you not? I mean, Sam Bankman-Fried's already doing this with FTX by tokenizing some equities. We will see the tokenization of the asset management industry. That's all coming too. And it massively reduces the cost. Anybody who's ever set up a fund knows how painful it is. So this is changing, and there are whole platforms building these kind of businesses out. And this is not me pontificating on a Friday afternoon. This is me saying, I'm talking to all of these people, and this is all happening.
When I look at these things, the Bank of America, the top custody bank, State Street, and BNY Mellon, and so many others, JP Morgan now offering crypto, you know, doesn't it come down to Wen Moon? We're seeing all the right information, all the right fundamental news, all the right players. This isn't about just YouTubers and influencers in the crypto space saying it's going to happen, it's going to happen. We're reporting on very real news that it is happening. But we're short the regulation. And as Bitwise Cryptocurrency Index Fund CIO predicts, next major bull run with positive regulation. And I think that's right. And let's hear about this again.
I think a little bit of perspective. The Bitwise 10 index is still up 250% over the last 12 months. It's up more over the last 12 months than the S&P 500 is over the past 8 years.
That's a massive number right there. Keep listening.
I agree that we're going through a little pause right now. That pause is driven by some uncertainty on how regulations are going to develop over the next 3 to 6 months. But here's the important thing. If the regulators in DC get it right, I think positive regulation could start the next major wave of a crypto bull market. So I do think this is a pause, but I think it's a pause that refreshes, and I'm excited about what comes next.
As we have seen in many areas of financial regulation since the global financial crisis, we all work together to continue reaping the collective benefits of a safe and secure global financial system. The rapid pace of innovation and its borderless nature calls for building international consensus, thus helping eliminate gaps in regulations that might provoke a race to the bottom. An early formation of an international consensus would also provide a smoother landscape for innovators, because the larger and more complex a system is, the bigger the shock when regulation is introduced. Because of the realm of crypto assets is developing so fast, regulators should be wary of recognizing them too strictly, because narrow definitions might become obsolete overnight. Instead, drawing on existing international principles for financial regulation, such as those on governance, auditing, client asset segregation, minimum capital, outsourcing, cybersecurity, and disclosure, could be applicable to publicly offered crypto assets and to crypto exchanges.
Second on the list, you know we got to talk about that money, Graham, because I got money on my mind and my mind on the money. We wrote it from $5 to $12.50. I think they're about to get bought out for at least $18, taken private with the help of Stellar Foundation. When the SEC sued Ripple, MoneyGram had to stop their operations, but it's all right. They hit that spin move. They hit that L1 juke move. Think about it. SEC sued Ripple, MoneyGram had to stop. Now Stellar swoops in to buy them. Who's the founder of Stellar? Jeb McCaleb. Let me tell you a little history about him. He started Mt. Gox, an exchange. Millions of dollars just disappeared. He didn't get touched. Then he helped start Ripple. Then he was forcefully told to leave. Never got touched. Then he started Stellar. During this lawsuit with Ripple, they don't even want to depose him. He's like the Teflon Don. And in order for MoneyGram to be bought, the SEC has to approve it. Who's working with who?